Well, Shabbat Shalom, everybody, and we'll rise and we'll bless the Talit. Baruch Atah Adonai Eloheinu Melech Haolam. Asher Kedeshanu B'Mitzvotav V'Tzivanu Lagid Tate Ba Tzitzit. Shema Yisrael, Adonai Eloheinu, Adonai Echad, Baruch Shem Kavod, Malkuto, Leolam Vaed. Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Blessed is his glorious. Hashem Areno, Mikol Ra, Amen. Sorry for the disturbance, sir. Okay, we are going to start on our last lesson on the Aleph Bet. So we've gone through 22 letters, and see here, I've got to connect this here, don't I? Torah is Tal, Bereshit. Aleph is the first, Mem is the middle, and the Tav is the last. At the very beginning is God's impression, which is a stamp of truth. Tav represents God's point of truth, an impression left on the soul as it comes into the body to reveal his truth in the world. Made up of the Dalet and the Nun, they spell Dam. Let's look at something that really reflects Yeshua. Scripture tells us that God made him who had no sin to be sin for us. You know, when I went to Bible college, just right after I got saved, I had such a problem. My professor said Yeshua was sin, took on sin. And I could never get that into my mind. He was sinless. So how could he take on sin? And no sin to be sin on our behalf, that we might become the righteousness or in right standing with God in him. Hebraic word for sin is chata. Now look at this. If you attach or add the word sin, chata, to the letter tav, that represents the cross, we get the word chatam. To a T structure. Morning, guys.
I'm not the investors today.
It didn't make a hill of beans to the executioner if the victim was hung with his arms straight out to the side or over his head, or if his feet were placed together or wide apart in an eagle spread fashion. The main idea for a crucifixion was to put as much pain Debbie, you got a talk up one?
The scripture says, no one shall see God and live.
No one shall see God and live. But we saw his son. Of course, you and I hadn't seen his son unless he... Because a lot of people have seen Jesus. It's interesting. Christianity is based on what we've heard, based on the faith, knowing that what we've heard is true. Anybody that is viewing this, if you can find a place to do Pesach, Passover, go to a Messianic Pesach, and you will see every little bit of the tradition points to Yeshua. Every bit. So I encourage you all to do that. It's a regular Seder. Seder means order, by the way. No more than a day or so, but anyway, it was a meat line. It was terrible. Can you imagine the stench that took place? I want you to envision this, because a lot of us, we just don't stop and stop to think. But you know, crucifixion was the most gruesome way to die. I mean, the hair was literally pulled out, Yeshua's hair. Why? Because they hated him so much. Why? Because so that's what Yeshua went through, all over his back. 39 stripes, because the law was, if you did 40, you would die, and whoever did the 40th would die. That's how strong the Roman law was. You went maximum of 39, because one more would have killed him. Well, Yeshua went through 39. And the flies that were what their sentence was. See, I cannot imagine that. But there are people in the eastern countries now that are being persecuted like that. ISIS. Dealing with Christians. Crucifying in the most horrendous ways. If you saw God, wouldn't that change your life forever? I mean, wouldn't you be a God nutso? You know, Jesus freak, Jesus nutso, whatever. You wouldn't care what anybody said or thought. Because you knew that you knew that you knew. That's why Jesus died. That's why Yeshua died. So that the people that saw him die and the people that saw him resurrected because they saw how he died made them believers. And it was written in the book for us to read and believe by faith, because we weren't there, obviously. Archaeologists have found that the executioner would take both feet, put them to the side, of the beam. Then they would take a huge nail with a piece of wood on the nail first, and they would put the nail in the ankle right now about all the screaming and the hollering that was taking place as people would walk and stare, look and watch people die. I couldn't do that. To walk by and watch somebody die like that. I don't get it. I don't see how people could do that. Let's go a little deeper with this word of truth, amet. We've got the aleph, the mem, and the tav. The smallest numerical unit of amet, namely the aleph, is omitted. What remains is met. And met means dead. So without the Father, we have no life. That's Hebrew. So if we are missing one part of truth out of our life, are from a false charge and do not kill the innocent or the righteous, for I will not acquit the guilty. Go far away from falsehood. There should be so many things going through your mind right now. There's so many going through mine, and if I just start one of them, I'm going to be in there on a rabbit trail. So, Emet. You see the two seagulls? Emet. Has a center involving the mem and ends with the ta. And here we go. Aleph, Bet, Gimel, Dalet, Hey, Vav, Zayin, Chet, Tet, Yud, Kaf. What is this? Final call. Lamed, Mem, final Mem, Nun, final Nun, Samek, Ayin, Fei, Pei, Zari. Kuf, Resh, Shin, Tav. Yud, Hey, Vav, Hey. Revelation 1:8, Isaiah 44:6, and Revelation 1:8. I am the Alpha and the Omega, says the Lord God, who is and who was and who is to come, the Almighty. Isaiah 44:6, thus saith the Lord, the King of Israel and his Redeemer, the Lord of hosts, Tzavaot, I am the first and I am the last, and there is no the author and perfecter of faith, who for the joy set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God. What was written on the cross? Yochanan, John 19:19-22 says, and Pilate wrote an inscription also. Rewrite what he wrote. The chief priest tells Pilate to change what was written. The inscription in Hebrew reads, Yeshua the Nazarene, the King of the Jews. The acronym where you take the first letters of the sequence, Yeshua Hana Tziv Venelech Hayah Hodin. Those letters You know what a bond servant is? When a master told the servant he was free, and a servant says, I don't want to go. The master, we know where we're going with this, the master would go to a doorpost and take a nail, pierce his ear against the doorpost. Saying, amen. Ephesians 2:14. For he himself is our peace, who made both groups into one and broke down the barrier of the dividing wall by abolishing in his flesh the enmity, which is a law of commandments contained in the ordinances, that in himself he might make the two into one new man, thus establishing his shalom. When we receive Yeshua, religion is the door of the sign of the cross. Pretty neat. Pretty simple. That's why Hebrew is so interesting. Shabbat is a special time for God's people. It means when we rest from our ordinary work and the cares of the previous week. It's time to focus on Adonai, Adonai, his word and family. The letters of Shabbat are interesting in their meaning. The Shin means to consume. Remember, it was either the heart of God or consume, devour, teeth. So the Shin means to consume, so that we no longer have to desire what we once lived for. Yeshua did all of that for us, if we would only believe and accept him. This concludes our primary learning of the 22 letters. I messed that up there, didn't I? God's Alephbet. You have no idea how humbling this time I have had with you has affected me and my walk. To go a-whoring. Revelation 22. Pay attention, says Yeshua. I am coming soon, and my rewards are with me to give to each person according to what he has done. I am the Alpha and the Tau, the first and the last, at the beginning and the end. Aspire to inspire before you expire, and take what you need and give the rest away. I want to ask once again that as we come upon this time of Pesach, you, I am a dead man or a dead woman. Please forgive me my sins. I can't live this way any longer. I relinquish myself to the only true God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. And I open up my heart to and thank you for saving me. Amen. Next week, Wanda will be back, and we will start on the Talit, and it's going to be a wonderful time. God bless you, and we're going to have Grandpa come up and say the Aaronic blessing. And until next week, Shabbat Shalom.